plant is a herbaceous plant growing to 45 to 60 centimeters tall. From a stout underground, succulent rhizome, it is normally evergreen but becomes deciduous during drought. Surviving drought due to the large potato-like rhizome that stores water until rainfall resumes. The leaves are pinnate 40 to 60 centimeters long with 6 to 8 pairs of leaflets 7 to 15 centimeters long. They are smooth, shiny, and dark green. The flowers are produced in small bright yellow to brown or bronze spadix 5 to 7 centimeters long, partly hidden among the leaf bases. Flowering is from mid-summer to early autumn. Welcome plant contains an unusually high water content of leaves, 91%, and petioles, 95%. It has an individual leaf longevity is at least 6 months, which may be the reason it can survive extremely well under inferior low light levels for 4 months without water. The plant has air purifying qualities for the indoor environment. A study from Department of Plant and Environment Science at the University of Copenhagen from 2014 shows that the plant is able to remove volatile organic compounds in its order of effectiveness, benzene, toluenes, ethyl, benzene, and xylene at a molar flux of around 0.1 per day. Welcome plant is part of the Araceae family, which is well known for many poisonous genera, such as Phellodendron, which contains calcium oxalate. Needle-like calcium oxalate crystals could irritate different sensitive skin parts, mucosa, or conjunctiva. Speculation and hysteria during the 2010 lead to a belief that welcome plant could be extremely poisonous. Extreme versions of this rumor claim that the plant could cause cancer and was even dangerous to touch, leading people to wear gloves when handling it. Given the fact that the plant has been used externally in traditional medicine, it's a very common office plant and is cultivated on a large scale, it's safe to assume that welcome plant is not very toxic. In fact, in an initial toxicological experiment conducted by the University of Bergen in 2015, an extract from welcome plant using brine shrimp as a lethality assay did not indicate lethality to the shrimp even at concentrations of extract up to 1 mg or 1 ml, providing disproving evidence for the assumption of welcome plant's toxic character. The scientists conducting the experiment found that, on the contrary, it could appear as though the extract contributed to improvements in vitality of the larvae. Welcome plant is grown as an ornamental plant mainly for its attractive glossy foliage. It can be kept outdoor as long as the temperature does not fall below around 15 degrees Celsius, 59 degrees Fahrenheit. Best growth is between 18 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius, 65 degrees to 79 degrees Fahrenheit. Net temperatures given its increase of leaf production. In temperature regions, it is grown as a house plant. Overwatering may destroy this plant. Appearing on the side of a dryness is preferable to risking tuber rot. Do not use leaf shiners as a quarter or 8-strength liquid fertilizer, such as fish emulsion or worm cast liquid, may be used once a month at the warmest period for potted specimens. Bright indirect light is best for welcome plant, although it will tolerate light levels as low as 270 LX, 35 FC, which is equivalent to the light 70 cm away from a 100 watts incandescent light bulb. Some sun will be tolerated very early in the morning for hot district, morning or afternoon for cooler district. Welcome plant may be propagated by leaf cuttings. Typically, the lower ends of detached leaves are inserted into a moist, gritty compost and the pot enclosed in a polythene bag. Though the leaves may well decay, succulent bulb-like structures should form into the compost, and this may be potted after produce new plants, and the process may take upwards of 1 year.